Evening, everyone. I'm Hannah Fisher from the UK. Probably seen some of my work and some of my spoken work as well. Still quite new to spoken pieces, but I'm giving it my best shot and I'm having a blast, so that's all that matters really. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you for allowing me to be host this evening. I've recorded a few pieces and they will be showing after this. So thank you, and I hope you enjoy the show. Two minds, two hearts, torn apart. Which, why, where, who? Do you do what you're supposed to do? Because he says that it's okay to dream and play the day away, to stick your finger up and say, fuck this life and what you say. Fair enough, you came to help me, feel me, grope me. Suffocate me. You never said that you love me. You just came to violate me. You were the one that made me hate me. Look at my life and you'll see through the lies that hide behind the words, the truth that hurts, the sadness that echoes in my words. Love you forever. Amen. What is it that you want from me? Pretend me? Happy me? Or just me? Don't play God with my life, son. God the Father, God the One, who tells me exactly who to be, to love thy neighbour as he loves me. But if I loved you like you love me, then I would die so miserably, so sad, so bad, so incomplete. Your life is nothing without me. Shut up saying you're nothing without me. It's God that taught me how to love you. Love you, love all, let them, love all you put me through. Trust you and love what you mean to me. Fuck this world and how it ostracized me, named me and labelled me as insecure, dependent on your love when all I needed was love from above. So go ahead, sit and ridicule me. You're nothing more than shit to me. It's my life, my choice, so don't try to tell me how and why people should love me. Look at your own life before you judge others. Those you conveniently call brothers. But there's no brotherly love that exists with this jealousy. The green-eyed monster will eat you alive while those you judge bathe in paradise. Paradise because they just live their life. Happy. Content. You're none of these things. And you'll never reach and achieve your dreams. Hoping. Wishing. All of the above. The only way to really show your love is to respect their life and what it's worth. Overload. She tells me how to breathe with angelic undertones, whispers her calm like an incessant drone. I don't want to sleep. What if I miss something? Focus and reload. Refresh the page. Adjust the lights, I'm coming on stage. The applause almost deafening as I enter. I squint, nothing's familiar. My clothes feel heavy and I start to scratch. Voice over, boom, pieces of me scattered, shattered, and my body is battered. People brush past and my skin is on fire. 1,000 needles stabbing. I climb higher, faster and stronger. I fight harder to leave. Furious at myself for not helping me and furious at me for not helping myself. Hold my breath for 4 seconds. I'm told that it helps. I'm not sure how or why or even when, but I know in 4 seconds I'm going to do it again to try to bring myself back into the room in an attempt to float above this doom. Zoom around, boom, there's no stopping me now. Boom, I'm locked in this room and their walls are starting to get a little closer and my heart will start to beat a little faster and my bed sheets start to feel a little tighter and my body will start to feel a little lighter and I'll levitate towards the ceiling. Count to four to induce the dreaming. Hold my breath to reduce the screaming. Hold on, always believing that I am a fighter and I'm still fighting. Attacked. I'm fine, I muttered, after contemplating shaving my head for the third time that day. Wishing, hoping, pleading that everything would fuck off and everyone would shut up, but wanting them to stay. My face is begging them to get closer, but my inferiority is pushing them away. Out of reach, and this weight on my chest pins me. It holds me on the spot and I can't get up. I can't get out. I can't free myself from this agony that sinks through me like acid. A pain I cannot liken to anything else because nobody will get it. Shut up, sit down and fucking shut up. Nobody's listening anyway. Nobody wants to hear it. Nobody understands it. It's better if you are just on your own. Breathe. 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 That last breath was too heavy. Now I can't breathe properly. How can breathing hurt so much? And why can't I stand up? Tears roll and roll and roll, falling from my jawline mindlessly, irrationally, senselessly. Breathe, just fucking breathe. How hard can breathing be? Fuck! Eyes are wild and confused and dazed and glazed over and phased, almost hungover, exhausted. Breathe, please. Breathe. Up inside my head, I hide. How I feel? Anxiety decides. What will it be? Something absurd. Usually unrelated. Fuck off, birds. Oh, there she blows, losing direction. Anger grows into affection. Losing focus, mind's a jungle. Words falling into a mumble jungle, fumble bungle. Anxiety strikes and I start to crumble. Tick tock tick, I hear it. Tick tock tick, I feel it. Tick tock tick, I smashed it. Bashed it, broke it, battered it dead. Anger surges, face is red, and the only thing left to greet me is that fucking bird still singing sweetly.